that is the monster amalgam, symbolic amalgam of all that which lies outside your realm of safety. You want to be safe? Forget that, right? That's not in the cards. You're not going to be safe. Well, then you have to be meta-safe. And that's way better, because then you're not safe, but you know how to cope with danger. Well, fine. That solves the problem. And maybe it's even a better solution, because if you're safe, then you just have to stay in your burrow. But if you can confront danger, then you can go wherever you want and you can have an adventure. And maybe that's what you need to do, is to go out and have an adventure. So you don't even want safety, because how exciting is that? Not, Dostoevsky said very clearly, let's say we made you perfectly safe. All that you had to do was eat cakes and worry yourself with the continuation of the species. What would you do? You'd smash it all down as soon as you possibly could, just so you had something interesting and challenging to do. So you don't want safety. You want to be able to cope with danger. That's a whole different thing. And this isn't, again, metaphysical. The clinical data on this is clear. When you treat someone for an anxiety disorder like agoraphobia, you do not get rid of their anxiety. You make them braver. That's way better. There's no going back. Like, once you're agoraphobic, your heart's not doing the, you know, it's missing beats now and then. It's like death, like the crocodile that's got the clock in its stomach. Death is after you. There's no going back to naivety. You don't get to be safe ever again. Well, so what happens? You get to be stronger. Well, hey, turns out that's a better bargain anyways. So